Hi, this is Reza Tangesani from HyperLyceum team, and in this series of video, I will explain few techniques for meshing components. As you know, for using fine element size could increase the accuracy of the simulation, but it would lead to longer computational time. So it is important to use fine element for areas with high stress gradient and large element for far region, which are not important. To do that, we need some techniques to sweep the element from small to large, which I explain few of them here. First, let's create a 3D geometry. Let's assume we need to increase the size of element from the center to the edges in this example, like it is shown in the top right figure. The first step is creating face partition as we are doing it now. We select this face and then this edge, and now we can create a sketch. The rectangle at the center is for the fine element. Because in this example we increase the element size in two steps, we need two outer rectangles. Then we connect these edges. At the end, we make these final rectangles. After finishing the sketch, we are ready to create cell partition. For this purpose, we select type as cell and we choose extrude sweep edges. We select these edges for partition and the direction after. You see, the part is divided in two components now. Now we move to the second one and select the edges. After that, we select the direction of the partition again. We keep doing it till the last component. Now the part is divided into a few pieces. Okay, perfect. Now we move to assembly module and we bring the geometry. In this example, there is no difference between dependent and independent feature. Now we skip all modules and we jump into the mesh module. In the mesh module, you see all of them are green, which represents the meshing technique. We need to change the outer cuboid into the sweep technique to able to increase the element size. Before redefining the sweep path, I need to explain what does it mean. The slide shows the sweep path and sweep profile. We can change the element direction in sweep profile, but the element size in sweep path is fixed. Although it explains the sweep path is perpendicular to sweep profile. So by considering these details, the mesh would look like this figure, and you can have a better understanding of them. These figures are taken from Abaqus documentation. In our example, in the first step, we want to increase the element size in the red arrow direction. So by considering the concept of the sweep path and sweep profile, we need to select one of these edges for each cuboid. In the second step, we want to increase the element size in the direction of the blue arrow, so we must select one of the blue lines for each cuboid. Now let's move on to the Abaqus software. At first, to have a better view over the part, we hide the surfaces. We change the view and we select these three species to redefine the sweep path direction. Here the sweep path direction should be rotational around the central cuboid. Now we move to the outer one and we must redefine the edges which are coming out of the plane. Although it might not change the meshing technique, I personally recommend choosing similar direction for all edges. We use 40 elements for the critical area, then we make sure to check this option to fix the nodes. As you can see, software duplicates the seeds to the outer edges because element size won't change in profile direction as we explained it in the PowerPoint file. However, these edges are still empty, which means we can use different number of elements. I use again 40 for this critical area. But for these edges, we use 20 because we want to increase the size of the element. We use 20 elements for the empty edges for the second step. Now we are ready to mesh the component. We mesh the component one by one to make sure everything is fine. Now we can see the whole part is being meshed and the element size has been increased in three directions, which are X, Y, Z. This approach is very useful for 3D geometries, which we are trying to define surface contact for some areas. However, this approach might have some negative sides. For example, there might be elements that their aspect ratio might be larger than 10, but in overall, it doesn't change the results. But I recommend you, whenever you are trying to use this approach, make sure that these areas are far from the critical area. I hope you enjoyed this video. In the next one, we're gonna explain the models with the holes in it. And if you're interested, you could also watch another video from one of our team members, Saman Hosseini, which is linked on top. If you have any question, please mention it in comments or in our Q&A session website. And until the next one, bye.
This video was made by Reza Tangistan. To find his contact information and his updated resume, please visit our website at hyperlinkceo.com. Reza is an expert in Abaqus, Python, Fortran, SolidWorks, and a few other engineering software. To plan an online session and discuss industrial and academic projects, please use the provided email under Reza's contact. The cost of projects vary depending on complexity of the work, can be discussed in advance. We look forward to working with you.